Today, we're actually going to talk about switch end stops on the MakerBase MKS Robin Nano version 2.0. Now, switch end stop is basically a creation of a circuit when this is actually depressed. So that creates current that it will run through. They're both very similar, but this one has actual circuitry on it that will smooth out the signal. So it's a little bit more complex of a end stop, but also offers more reliability. So I'm going to show you, first of all, where the end stops are located. So what we have here is our X minimum, our Y minimum, our Z minimum, and then our Z max. Now, the pin order for these is your signal pin, then your ground, and then your voltage. So signal, ground, voltage. And that will be the same for all of your end stops. So to connect one of these up, in the case of this regular switch end stop, you have two wires here. You have a red and a black. So in this case, it's going to be signal for red, and for black, it's going to be ground. In this case, you have red, black, and green. So red is voltage, black is your ground, and green is your signal. So I'll show you how to attach these real quick. So if I take this one right here, and I want to attach it to our X minimum, the red's going to be on the outside, and the black's going to be in the center because red is going to be signal in this case. So for the other one, to attach the wire, the signal has to be on the outside. So I'm going to attach it to our Y-axis and show you what this looks like. So you have your green on the outside, which is signal, black in the center, which is ground, and then you have your red, which is voltage. So it will power your end stop. So to power your end stop, you're going to take this and you're just going to use the notched connector and push it together. So now let's load firmware. But before we do that, I'm actually going to do this on only the power that goes off of USB to test the board. So I'm going to take the jumper. It's normally on these two pins for direct power. Let me get this out of the way here. So it would normally be on these two pins right here when you're powering off of your direct power right here. But since we're using USB, we're going to move it over to the other two pins and then push it down. Next, we're actually going to take our USB cable and connect it right here. And this will show you that the actual one that takes voltage actually will work when actuated and show you a light. But for now, what we're going to do is we're actually going to unplug this and we're going to set this up to load firmware. So I'm going to actually just take out the 120 megabit card and place it inside our adapter so that we can then place this in our computer. So, like always, I'm going to start with the SD card to show you that it says Robin Nano 35.cur and it's in all capital letters, which means that it was recently loaded. The cur stands for current. So now I'm actually going to go over to VS Code and I'm going to load the downloaded Marlin from the most current Marlin build by clicking on Explorer. Then open folder. Then I'm going to go to my downloads folder. I'm going to click on Marlin once, Marlin twice. Then I'm going to say select folder. Inside here, we're going to search on a couple of things. First, we're going to go over to the Marlin folder, the source folder, the core folder, then boards.h. In here, you're going to locate board underscore MKS underscore Robin underscore Nano underscore V2. You're going to highlight that and you're going to right click and copy it. Then you're going to close out of boards.h. You're going to minimize the core and the source folder. Then you're going to go to configuration.h. And you're going to search on motherboard so that you can highlight the current ramps configuration and paste yours in. Then we're going to scroll up and we're going to change the serial port to 3. And then we're going to search on end stops. So the end stop that we're searching for settings, I'm going to show you first. These are the ones that are currently enabled. If you want to enable another one, you would have to backspace. In this case, we're going to use the Z max for our end stop. And then they have other settings here for float state. So what this talks about is basically there is circuitry that smooths out your signal so that instead of being like 2.3, it's like 3 for either high or low. But down here, we're interested in inverting. The Y end stop that has all the circuitry on it, we actually need to invert in this case because it will say that it's triggered when it is not. So we want it to say open. So I'm changing the true to a false to take care of that. So now to set up the build, we're going to go to platformio.ini. And right now it's set to the mega chipset. So we need to change that. So we're going to search on Robin. And down here, we have our actual environment, which is the MKS Robin Nano 35. So I'm going to right click and copy that. Then I'm going to scroll back up and I'm going to change my environment for my default environment to that. Next, we're actually going to click on the checkbox to build. Now, if you're having trouble building, sometimes you need to build twice. So you'll have to click the checkbox twice to build. And also you can use the garbage bin to clean your previous build. So what I'm going to do right now is I'm actually going to click the checkbox to build. And then I'll show you what happens. So now the build is completed, and as you can see, it says successful. So in order to load this on our drive, what we need to do is go to the .pio folder, then go to build, then go to MKS Robin. Then we're going to right click on it and say reveal in Explorer. We're going to go one folder deep, and here's our actual file. So we're going to right click on this and we're going to send to our SD card. Then we're going to remove this from the computer after we verify that it's there, as you can see right here. And notice how it says bin for binary. And we're going to remove it and install it in our board. To install, what we're going to do is we're going to take the adapter. We're going to remove the 128 megabit SD card, and we're going to insert it into our board. Now, to load it, what we need to do is we need to be on USB power. Notice how I have the two pins set for that. And I'm going to insert the USB, which will then provide power. And this will also load your Marlin firmware. In order to test this, what we need to do is open a Prunerface. We then need to connect to the actual printer. And as you can see, on the board it says connecting, and it says printer is now online. So to test the actual end stops that we have, we want to see what the state of the end stops currently is. So we're going to type M119 and press Enter. And that's the G code to say what's the end stop status. And as you can see, the X minimum and Y minimum are both open. That's because I had to invert the Y minimum so it wouldn't say triggered. Then you can see down here for Z minimum and Z max that they both say triggered. That's because no end stop is connected. So what I'm going to do now, I'm actually going to trigger the first end stop with my finger, and I'm going to then press M119 again to check the status. So as you can see, it says triggered. So I'm going to remove my finger, and I'm gonna press M119 again, and now it says open. So I'm gonna try the same for the other end stop, and now that says triggered, and I'll release my finger, and it now says open. And just so you know, MakerBase was kind enough to give me a board for this tutorial, but I will be placing Amazon affiliate links in the description for your convenience. And please like and subscribe, and have a nice day.